Good morning.
I have invited my family out today to help me with a demonstration. All right, Mom, could you come here? All right, so we're gonna have you stand right about here. And what I need you to do is stay in the spot and turn at a constant angular velocity. Yep, turn. Excellent. You're doing an excellent job turning at a constant angular velocity. Yep, do an excellent job. Just keep moving at a constant angular velocity. Awesome. Good. Evan, could you come here for a moment, please?
Absolutely.
Could you please stand right next to Grandma? Mm-hmm. And you're going to hold, put your arm in arm there. Grandma, do the same thing. And Evan, go ahead. Yep, there you go. Doing an excellent job. Good job. And please pause. Kate, could you come here, please? You're going to be right next to Evan.
Woohoo!
And Grandma, go ahead. Keep going. Good. That's good. And if you could please pause. Carrie, if you could come here, please.
Yeah. Ooh, this is getting exciting.
And go ahead, Grandma. Good job, Grandma. You're doing an excellent job. Kate, come on, catch up here. Just a little bit faster. There you go. All right. And pause, please. Chris, could you come here, please? Chris, come on over. Right here, right next to your wife. And go ahead, Grandma. Go ahead, Grandma. Are you okay, Grandma?
I'm fine.
Everything good? Everything? Evan, everything good? Uncle Chris, come on! Keep up here! Okay. And if you could please pause right there for me. Just pause right there for me. Okay. So the important thing to realize here is if Uncle Chris could actually keep up, you all would have had the same angular velocity. You're all moving through the same number of degrees in the same amount of time. So it's the same angular velocity. However, I think you would agree that something was different. Right?
I'm short of breath and Evan is.
Anybody have any ideas what was different?
The distance that we were traveling.
So the linear distance traveled is different for each of you, even though the angular distance is the same. So as the radius increases, the linear distance traveled when moving through a circle, which is called arc length, increases. And so you also have a linear velocity when you're moving in a circle, which is called the tangential velocity. And the tangential velocity also increases with the radius. So again, the important piece to realize here is with an increased radius, we have an increased arc length. Again, arc length, the equation, equals radius times the change in angular position. And we also have an equation for tangential velocity. The tangential velocity equals the radius times the angular velocity. And with an increased radius, we have an increased arc length and an increased tangential velocity. And that V sub t equals r times omega, that tangential velocity equals the radius times the angular velocity. With an increased radius, we have an increased tangential velocity. And remember, just like the arc length equation, you need to use radians in the equation for tangential velocity. So that angular velocity needs to be in radians per second. Thank you very much for your help today. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you. Thank you. Come here.
Oh, yeah. How about, are you gonna check this to make sure we're like underneath?
Well, yes.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
All right, yeah. Nice
for your help.
It was fun.
May I call the Johnsons and tell them?
Can I go get a hat?
I need to brush my teeth.
Actually, I didn't get breakfast.